The chapter is 12, and we're going to take a look at verses 1 through 4. Hebrews chapter 12, and the verses are 1 through 4. Reading from the English Standard Version of the Bible, there you will find these words. The Bible reads, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider him who endured from sinners such hostility against himself, so that you may not grow weary or faint-hearted. In your struggle against sin, you have not yet resisted to the point of shedding your blood." It is from this passage of scripture that I would like to draw upon the blackboards of your minds and preach from the subject, succeeding spiritually. Succeeding spiritually. As Christians, if we get nothing else out of this message, we must at least get this point, that we need endurance. We cannot overcome suffering. We cannot overcome sorrow. We cannot overcome setbacks in the absence of endurance. Endurance is absolutely essential in carrying out the service of our Lord. Go to the next slide. Endurance is the stamina we have to keep moving forward when we are fatigued physically, mentally, and spiritually. Endurance is the steadfastness to never give up when we are stressed out. Endurance is the patience to continue to trust in God when the conditions in our lives are not favorable. And endurance is needed to lay aside every weight, to put off every sin, and to run with purpose the race that is set before us. In Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1, the Bible reads, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us." My brothers and sisters, it is not enough for us to run this race, but it is very important that we finish this race. According to 2 Timothy chapter 4 and the verse is 7, to finish this race in the Lord called life is to succeed spiritually. In order to run and finish this Christian race, we need to have commitment. We need to have confidence. We need to have compassion. We need to have cooperation. And we need to have contentment. So we can go ahead and skip this slide and move on to the next slide as we go to our very first point, which talks about what we need to have in order to succeed. So how do we succeed? Well, PowerPoint number one is this: commitment to Christ is needed to succeed spiritually. Listen to your Bible as we go to Proverbs chapter 16 and the verse is 3. In Proverbs chapter 16 and the verse is 3, the Bible reads, "Commit your work to the Lord and your plans will be established." Again, commit your plans to the Lord. Commit your ways to the Lord and your work to the Lord, and your plans will be established. My brothers and sisters, unfortunately, some of us fall short of pleasing God because we are not totally committed to him nor to his work. Now, the reason for this is because many insist on inserting our will over God's will. But we need to understand on tonight that spiritual success demands complete abandonment of self and the complete acceptance of God's will. Even when we are led to believe we might have a better way, we must understand on tonight that the will of God makes everything work together for our good, but not only for our good, but most importantly for his glory, when we are committed to fulfilling his will, according to Romans chapter 8, verse 28. But not only must we have commitment to Christ, but we must also understand that confidence in Christ is needed to succeed spiritually. Confidence in Christ is needed to fulfill, to succeed spiritually. We read about that when we take a look at 1 John chapter 5 and the verses 14. In 1 John, the chapter is 5, and the verse is 14, the Bible reads, "And this is the confidence that we have towards him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us." The condition of this world and our nation has caused a breakdown in trust, as well as a breakdown in confidence. This lack of confidence and this lack of trust has eventually made its way into our families, and it has also made its way into the church. And regardless of the conditions surrounding us, we need to understand on tonight that Christ is still the way, the truth, and the life, according to John chapter 14 and the verses 6. And so we can safely place our confidence in Christ. It doesn't matter who wins an election. We can place our confidence in Christ. He never misrepresents nor undermines. Trusting Christ is what leads to spiritual success. Our third point on this evening is this. It's found in Luke chapter 7 and the verse is 13. It's there we find that compassion like Christ is needed to succeed spiritually. And so we must have commitment to Christ, confidence in Christ, but we must also have compassion that is just like the compassion of Jesus. Listen to your Bible as we take a look at Luke chapter 7 and the verses 13, and we see the compassion of Christ, where the Bible reads, "And when the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her and said to her, 'Do not weep.'" The Savior that we serve is not emotionless, but rather he has compassion. Not just any compassion, but he has great compassion for each and every one of us. This compassion was displayed because he was touched by the infirmities of others. He healed the lame, he healed the halt, and he healed the blind. We attain spiritual success when we are compassionate also by praying for the sick. We are compassionate also when we help the needy. We are being compassionate also when we comfort the bereaved. Because if Jesus was walking this planet right now, these are the very things that he would be doing, and it is our responsibility to follow his word, his will, his way with others that we come in contact with. This is how we succeed spiritually. But not only that, it brings us to our fourth point, where cooperation with Christ is needed to succeed spiritually. Listen to your Bible as we listen to the words of the Apostle Paul. In 1 Corinthians chapter 3, and the verses are 5 through 9. 1 Corinthians, the chapter is 3, and the verses are 5 through 9. The Bible reads, "What then is Apollos? What is Paul? Servants through whom you believe, as the Lord assigned to each. I planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the growth. So neither he who plants nor he who waters is anything, but only God who gives the growth. He who plants and he who waters are one, and each will receive his wages according to his labor. For we are God's fellow workers." You are God's field, God's building. You know, some of us fail to work for Christ as we should, because we get too busy trying to figure out who's going to receive the glory, who's going to receive the credit. Well, we just read in the Bible that whether you plant or whether you water, You are nothing more than a functionary in the greater scheme of God's plan of redemption. Because the only one that should ever receive the glory for anybody coming to Christ is not the one who taught that person, not the one who taught them later, not the one who planted, not the one who waters, but God and God alone, because God is the one who gives the growth. He is the one who gives the increase. And so as Christians, we have to learn not to make excuses, not to neglect the work that is at hand, or fail to cooperate with Christ in carrying out his commission. Because if we are doing what God will have us to do, we reap the benefits and the rewards along with the Savior in bringing people to Almighty God. And so when we work for Christ, we are not only working for Christ, but we are also working with Christ. He goes with us, and he speaks through us, through his word, as we share God's word with those we call, invite, and evangelize. These were Jesus' last words to his disciples in Matthew chapter 28, verses 18 through 20. Where he says, all power has been given unto me in heaven and in earth. Therefore, go into all nations, teaching the gospel. He that believes and is baptized shall be saved. That's Mark chapter 16, verse 15 through 16. But we need to go and make disciples. And they, that whoever you believe, whoever you baptize, go out and baptize. Baptize in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. And whatsoever I have commanded you, lo, I am with you. Teach them all those things. You know what? You all are messing me up tonight. You know, I can quote that scripture in my sleep. And I'm sitting here looking at Luke 24, Mark 16, and Mark chapter 28. Y'all need to correct me when I'm messing up like this. I'm looking like a fool to everybody on Facebook right now. And so we need to understand, you know what, let's go ahead and just read it now since I don't just put it out there. Matthew chapter 28, and the verses are 18 through 20. At least I got 18 right. And Jesus came and said to them, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And this is why I wanted to quote this verse, because of this part. And behold, Jesus says, I am with you always to the end of the age. The point is, when we do what God will have us to do, he is with us every step of the way. Amen? Amen. All right, I got one more point. And that point is, contentment through Christ is needed to succeed spiritually. Listen to your Bible as we go to Philippians chapter 4, and the verses are 11 through 13. Philippians chapter 4, and the verses are 11 through 13. Hear what the Apostle Paul had to say in regards to contentment. He says, not that I am speaking of being in need, for I have learned in whatever situation I am to be content. I know how to be brought low, and I know how to abound. In any and every circumstance, I have learned the secret of facing plenty and hunger, abundance and need. His secret is, I can do all things through him who strengthens me. We need to understand that discontentment is prevalent in today's world. Humanity is trying to find contentment through all the wrong things. They're trying to find contentment through possession. They're trying to find contentment through pleasure. They're trying to find contentment through popularity. But we need to know on tonight that real and lasting contentment is found only in Jesus Christ. As the song we've just sung, as the deer pants, Jesus satisfies the longing soul, and it is only he who brings spiritual success. And so I want to close on tonight by quoting a poem. And the poem starts off by saying, make straight my path, Lord, and let me not stray. In the life and the truth, lead me to the way. Make firm my steps, Lord, in you make them secure. Strengthen them for me with the faith to endure. Make steady my feet, Lord, keep them from slipping. To the things of the world, keep my soul from falling. Make my heart right, Lord. On your way, let me dwell, so I may be kept from the fires of hell. Make straight my path, Lord. Make me be Christ-seeking. For I put my hope in trusting you for safekeeping. In order for us to be what God would have us to be, we have to trust Jesus. And for as long as we are walking in this world, we have to endure. The Bible tells us in Galatians chapter 6, verse 7, be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever we sow shall we also reap. And when you drop down to verse 9, he says, do not grow weary in well-doing, because in due season we shall reap if we faint not. The key to succeeding spiritually is to stay with Christ and never give up. Don't quit. Even when you preach the gospel to others, don't quit. Even when you forget what the scriptures say in the middle of a sermon, you keep going. Don't quit. Even when you're sharing the gospel with your coworkers and your neighbors and your friends, and they want to talk about you and they want to close the doors in your face, don't quit. Even when people laugh at you for trusting in Jesus, even after you've lost a job, even after a marriage has failed, even after your kids have decided to go in a different direction, don't you quit. Because if you have it in you to succeed spiritually, you will reap all that has been sown from God's holy book, the Bible. Just don't quit. Don't give up. Stay in him. And so maybe you're not a Christian on tonight. You need to ask yourself where you stand. You need to ask yourself where you stand in regards to all that is happening around you. If you're outside of Christ, you're not saved. And so to endure in a state of darkness, there is no glory in that. You have to give up darkness. Walk in the light as he is in the light. And if you walk in the light as he is in the light, that doesn't mean that darkness is not going to try and overcome you ever again. Darkness is going to try. The devil doesn't give up. He may try you for a minute, and when you withstand him, he'll back away for a season, but he's coming back because he knows that he still has time to drag you back into the world and keep you in the world until such a time that Jesus comes again. But your responsibility, if you are outside of Christ, is to do what the song is that we're about to sing, and that is, I surrender all. If you try to hold on to any piece of yourself, you will fail miserably. But if you surrender all to Jesus Christ, surrender all to God, cast your cares upon him because he cares for you, and you just stay in him, if you just endure, you will succeed. You've already done the first thing to change your life for the better. And that is by hearing his word on tonight, according to Romans 10:17. Do you believe what you've heard? Do you believe that Jesus is who he says he is? Do you believe that God is a rewarder of those that diligently seek him, according to Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6? Then take this time, take this moment to resolve in your mind and show it through action by bringing forth fruits meet for repentance, according to Matthew chapter 3, verse 8. Confess Christ to be the Son of the living God, according to Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10. Be baptized. Have your sins washed away in that watery grave, according to 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 21. And God will forgive you of your sins, according to Acts 2:38. He'll make you a new creature in Christ Jesus, according to 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. What kind of creature? A creature that now knows the absolute necessity of having Jesus in their lives, who understand how critical it is to have Jesus as their Lord, that submits to Jesus as their Savior, and is resolved to endure from this point forward. God stands ready to add you to his church. But maybe you are a Christian. You have obeyed the gospel. You know what it means to endure. You know what it means to be a child of God. But maybe at times you have found yourself getting weak, feeling like giving up, feeling like going in another direction, taking the path of least resistance. Those temptations are there. From the weakest of us to the strongest of us, there has always been a thought that has been planted in our mind to say, quit, give up. Has that voice gotten louder? Have you been willing to listen to that voice more than listening to the voice of Almighty God? This is your opportunity to come forward and ask for prayers for strength to endure, so that you don't quit, so that you don't give up. Stay focused on the points that we talked about on this evening. Apply them, inculcate them, do the things that we have heard, so that we are not guilty of being hearers only, but be a hearer and a doer. Set forth this week and do what thus saith the Lord. And God has a way of turning your midnight into day. He has a way of making your crooked way straight. He has a way of picking you up even when you are down. We just have one job. Don't quit. Wherever you are on tonight, make a wise-hearted decision while together we stand and sing the song that has been selected.